with his open eye, naked eye, the Vishnu roop of the Chaturbhuja. And you know this slogan of Yapyonta Pravishya Bhamava Jamimamma Sattam, all the praising words of Dhruva. So when he got that opportunity, now the Lord is asking, oh my dear Dhruva, having seen me, now what do you want? Whatever boon you want, you ask. This poor child, he doesn't know what to ask. Because he was not elevated into that. He was completely in a dilemma. And moreover, he was so excited seeing this beautiful form of the Lord. And it was so enchanting in his mind, he stuck up there. That the Lord himself told, oh my dear Dhruva, I am going to give two boons. You will become the king of this earth for a quite long time, and after death, you will become the star of this universe. So when he got this two boon, the Lord disappeared. Then later on, Dhruva realized, oh my God, when I was looking at this form, I thought this form will be there ever. I never thought this form will disappear. Really regretting that I could have asked such a boon by which I could see this form always. Now the earth is there, the country is there, all these paraphernalia are there, but except the divine form for which I did all my penance. Now what is the use of everything? Is it going to make me happy? I really missed. So he started recruiting on that. But the same thing you can see in the heart of Nachiketas. When he got all this kind of offerings from Yamaraj, now he's telling Yamaraj, you can keep all these things in your own hand. Because these things may enchant me for a few days. But I know this whole body has to decrease the name. It just flow. Everyone has to go through this experience. Nobody can stop it. So what I am saying, I am holding on. My own words, I don't want to leave that boon. Whatever I ask, I am speaking on to that third boon. Give me the answer about the unknown. And take me to that plane of level of experience so I can confidently say, I realize that too. That answer you can give. Because you are very efficient, you are so, you are the real teacher, you are the master, you know that. And having seen you, or people like, or the master like you, will I ever look for the things which I can get it from the ordinary voucher? So I don't want those things. That I can get it anyway. So give me the answer for my question. So he was insisting on his question. And Yamaraja was so happy. Now we are concluding the Prathama Adhyaya. Now the second chapter is so interesting. There the Yamaraj is giving, he is giving the answer one by one. So tomorrow we will take this shloka. So tomorrow onwards we are entering to the real talk. Now the question is clear. Yamaraj realized that Nachiketas won't leave from this question. And what is the question? And people are talking about the soul, unknown. And everyone is, thinking that they know that unknown. But they know only about the body. They don't know anything about the soul and all. They don't know anything what is inside. Even when anybody asks this question, see, you introspect on this question. This question is, who are you? You just introspect on this question. Then you can see that answer also, you don't know much about it. If you sincerely know, you just think about that. Then you can understand, you don't know the answer. Suppose you are saying, I am a man. When you say you are a man, you are attributing this manhood by identifying the body. Now let me ask this same question. When you were in the womb of your mother, you became man or woman. at the time of the, you know, during the third month of the pregnancy of the mother, at 90 days, isn't it? The gender needs to get separated. Now the second month and first month, your gender that never, you know, identified or turned out. No, who are you that time? ആരായിരുന്നു നിങ്ങൾ? ആണാന്ന് പറയാൻ പറ്റൂ? പറയൂ നിങ്ങൾ. അപ്പൊ നിങ്ങൾ പറയണം ഫീച്ചസ് ആയി അമ്മയുടെ ഗർഭപാത്രത്തിൽ ഒരു ഭ്രൂണം അല്ലേ, അത്രയേ ഉള്ളൂ. പിന്നെ നിങ്ങൾ ആണായി പെണ്ണായി, ഈവൻ ആണെന്നും പെണ്ണെന്നും നമ്മൾ പറയുമ്പോൾ നമുക്കറിയാം ഏതാണ് ചെറുപ്പം, മധ്യവയസ്കത, ബാല്യം, കൗമാരം. ദേഹിനോസ്മിന്യതാ ദേഹി കൗമാരം യൗവനം ചില ഏത് ആണ് ഇന്ന് പറയുന്ന ആണല്ല, കുറെ കഴിഞ്ഞു. അപ്പൊ നമുക്കറിയാം ഈ ആണല്ല, കാരണം രാത്രി ഉറക്കത്തിലും നമ്മളുണ്ട്. പക്ഷെ ആ സമയത്ത് നമ്മുടെ ബോഡി ഐഡന്റിഫിക്കേഷൻ ഉണ്ടോ? കമോൺ, ഉണ്ടോ? ഇനി സ്വപ്നം നിങ്ങൾ കാണും. സ്വപ്നത്തിൽ ഈ ബോഡിയിലാണോ നിങ്ങൾ സ്വപ്നം കാണുന്നത്? ആണോ? മീൻസ് ഈ ബോഡി ഉപയോഗിച്ചിട്ടാണോ സ്വപ്ന സ്ഥലത്ത് പോകുന്നത്? ആണോ? യു ആർ കംപ്ലീറ്റ്ലി ഡിറ്റാച്ച് ഫ്രം ദ ബോഡി ആൻഡ് യു ആർ നോ ഗോയിങ് ഇൻ യുവർ ഓൺ, ഇസ്ൻ്റ് ഇറ്റ്? സോ വെൻ യു ഇൻട്രോസ്പെക്ട് യു വിൽ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് യു ആർ നോട്ട് ദിസ് ബോഡി. നൗ ഹു ആർ യു? ഇഫ് യു സേ ഐ ഹാവ് സം ഇമോഷൻസ്, ആർ യു ദ ഇമോഷൻസ്? വെൻ യു സേ ഐ ആം എ പ്രൊഫഷണൽ എഞ്ചിനീയർ ഓർ ഡോക്ടർ ഓർ എ ലോയർ ഓർ അക്കൗണ്ടന്റ് എക്സെട്ര എക്സെട്ര, വാട്ട് ഡസ് ഇറ്റ് മാറ്റർ? ആർ യു ദാറ്റ്? Come on. That's all your information. Whatever you gathered through your professional skill and through your university degrees, that's all. You are not the profession. One day you have to quit the job. Isn't it? Now, are you the ego? In deep sleep, your ego is not there. And your ego is also constantly changing. When you were young, your ego was something different. The more you are growing, you are adjusting your ego. Then who are you then? Are you the memory? Come on. The whole sleep you analyze, in the sleep there is no memory, there is no ego, there is no emotion, there is no intellection. But still you are there in the dormant sleep, in the subtle sleep. Who are you then? Then that point you have to answer, truly saying, truly analyzing, I don't know about myself. I exist. I am there, but I don't know, because I don't know who is this I. Are you getting the point? When you deeply analyze, your answer will be, I don't know about myself. That is unknown. Some unknown factor about yourself is still lying. You know only one part. You don't know much deeper part. That is what we are going to reveal. That is the secret of contemplation. Unknown becomes known. Naalam adhu namukku adine kurichu koodal detail ayittu padikkam. Okay? Is it interesting? Is it interesting? Okay. Ellavarum pusthavam kodu illai. Ningal pusthavam undengil ningal padikkam.